You pray earnestly for a loved one to get healed, yet they die. You go on a job interview and you pray, God, please give me this job. I need it. You know this. Yet you are rejected. And when you express disappointment to someone, they say, trust God, man. He knows best. Have faith in him. And sometimes you're like, really? Doesn't God want me to succeed? Doesn't he want me to prosper as he says? Can I catch a break already? Well, I know the feeling. I often have to encourage myself like David did in 1 Samuel chapter 30. Remember when David and his men returned to their home base at Ziklag and found it raided and burned by the Amalekites? Their families were taken captive, and understandably, they were furious and they blamed David. Verse 6 of 1 Samuel chapter 30, NLT version says, David was now in great danger because all his men were very bitter about losing their sons and daughters, and they began to talk of stoning him. But David found strength in the Lord his God. In his distress, David sought the Lord for strength and guidance, and God gave him certain instructions which he followed. David and his men launched a surprise attack on the Amalekites, defeated them, and recovered all that was stolen from them. David kept his faith in God. Likewise, I want to encourage somebody today to encourage yourself in the Lord. Keep the faith and know that God will come through for you too. The Bible reminds us in Psalms 121 verses 2 to 3 that even though we may not see it, God is always working on our behalf. My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not let you stumble. The one who watches over you will not slumber. In Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1, we are encouraged to have faith in our God. Faith shows the reality of what we hope for. It is the evidence of things we cannot see. We must be confident in the promises of God that are yes and amen. 2 Corinthians 1 verse 20. For all of God's promises have been fulfilled in Christ with a resounding yes, and through Christ, our amen, which means yes, ascends to God for his glory. In a practical sense, when your day just doesn't even seem to be going right, when the times are uncertain, when our prayers seemingly go unanswered, when your faith is being tested, do not waver, do not give up, do not give in, don't be like a seesaw. I've seen it written, and this is so reassuring. Remember that what appears to be silence from God doesn't mean he's absent, and the delay to us is not necessarily denial. So while we may not understand these trials, keep the faith. 2 Corinthians 4:16 to 18 says, that is why we never give up. Though our bodies are dying, our spirits are being renewed every day. For our present troubles are small and won't last very long. Yet they produce for us a glory that vastly outweighs them and will last forever. So we don't look at the troubles we see now. Rather, we fix our gaze on things that cannot be seen. For the things we see now will soon be gone, but the things we cannot see will last forever. In Psalm 77 verses 11 to 12, we are encouraged to remember the faithfulness of our God. But then I recall all you have done, O Lord. I remember your wonderful deeds of long ago. They are constantly in my thoughts. I cannot stop thinking about your mighty works. And Romans 10:17 reminds us to draw on the word of God for that reassurance we need in the tough times, so that our hearts and minds are aligned with the Holy Spirit. It says, so faith comes from hearing, that is, hearing the good news about Christ. Keep the faith. It is well. God is with us. Let us go forth now and always with renewed faith, trusting God's perfect plan for our lives.